So, the way the party is kicked off in this particular instance, since it's a costume party, is with the invitation. So what we did is we actually went to the AMC website where you can Mad Men yourself, which is awesome.
So much fun.
Frankly. And I frankly think I look a hell of a lot better on this than I do in real person. Anyways, what we did is we took the backdrop after we Mad Men'd ourselves and we cut and pasted it onto an actual PowerPoint slide. So there were two different versions. And then what we did is we took a nice little font that was reminiscent of the 60s. And this is actually a little bit larger for your viewing pleasure. But we cut them down into 5x7 pieces and printed them out on heavy cardstock and mailed them to each of our invitations, each of our recipients, rather. So what I think is nice is in this day and age, there's so few people who actually mail an invitation anymore.
Absolutely.
It's kind of fun.
Evites. I love hard copy invitations.
It was a real hard copy invitation. And I think when you're asking someone to come as someone from a show or any type of costume, they're worthy of an actual invitation.
Absolutely.
And our little funny tagline.
There were no Evites in the 60s.
No, there were no Evites in the 60s. And it says, Don, as in Don Draper, your favorite Mad Men outfit, character or period-esque, and come and party. So this is what we did, and we sent them out to each of our recipients before the party. That was our first clue for the actual setting of the ambiance of the party. Next, what we did is, frankly, there's not a lot of room for decorations.
We are the decorations.
Exactly.
We come in costume.
Honestly, some of the costumes that arrived were spectacular. Jen, in particular, had a hairpiece that rocked.
My wiglet.
Her wiglet. She looked phenomenal.
So
I actually got my hair done in an updo. I'm not going to lie.
So good.
There was so much hairspray in that hairdo that it lasted until 3 o'clock the next day after sleeping through it.
Thank goodness you cooked before.
Thank God I cooked before. Exactly. So watching everyone walk in the door, that's your decorations right there. But if you need something to go beyond that, I'd suggest calling family members. Like, for example, antique cigarette lighters, that kind of thing. Old ashtrays that your mother or your great aunt might have, that kind of stuff. Fun things to put around the room. And along that vein, what we also did was to print out some advertisements, given the nature of the show, from the 60s. So if you'd like, you can put them in frames, for example, something like a Campbell Soup one. There's an awful lot of cigarette ads back in the day. Feel free to post them around. Hair color, does she or doesn't she?
Oh, I love it.
I know. Simpler time, but actually some really fun reading material. And if you post them along the room, it makes for a really fun party atmosphere and something fun for everyone to look at. And per usual, we did our CD. CDs are always so important. Go ahead, Jen.
Shall I?
So the best part about iTunes these days is once you actually download a lot of the songs, they'll custom make the cover for you if you flip it over. And what it did is it took all the covers from each of the actual songs and put them in a little bit of a collage for you. So there's songs like...
Moon River,
absolutely. Blue Velvet.
They Kissed Me.
The Girl from Ipanema. My father played
video.
It on the organ growing up.
Look for that one, Lipstick.
And if you
Misty.
Feel... Misty. I actually love Misty. And if you feel really ambitious, what we did also was you can print out that same invitation, just take that same thing and print it out on a CD cover label so it looks even cuter. And it's a nice take-home gift for each of the guests. Last but not least, no party's complete without a game, obviously. And so a lot of the husbands who had been dragged to the party and made to dress up, by the way, they had a great time,
they
FYI.
So
once they got there, they were totally fine.
Spray gray hair.
Spray gray hair. Exactly, it was fabulous. So what we did is a quick quiz, and the winner who got the most questions right actually won a bottle of champagne. So sample questions include...
Let's see. Which company is not a client of Sterling Cooper? Lucky Strike Tobacco, Kodak, Playtex, or American Airlines?
Answer, Playtex. They actually had a different feminine product. but there were also some questions, even if you didn't watch the show, you could still be involved. So questions that were just representative of that era in particular. So something along the lines of Kennedy's assassination, things like that. And so we just handed them around. Everyone got their chance during the party to mull about, take their time with the answers, pass them in. At the end, the recipient got, the winner got a bottle of champagne.
Which was so much fun.
Exactly.
Had such a great time.
Yeah, it was fun.
Kudos.
Yeah.